population is, it's because they have these ongoing star formations, so the young stars dominate. But the mixture of stars within a galaxy are much more complex. So you can, for example, not say that these late types, which appear to be young, have no old stars. That's not true. They have old stars. But the light is mainly dominated from the younger stars because they are so much brighter. So it would be very difficult to actually associate an accurate evolution scale with the tuning fork. It's more, you have to see the classification more in a sense of, okay, I put objects together in a box which seems similar, so they have to have similar mechanisms going on to get where they are, or might be in the same stage.
So it's not necessarily saying you start here and end up here, but more of a...
It's not that easy. There is some resemblance. There is some resemblance to that, so you definitely, at some point, you need a galaxy which strongly forms stars to produce one of the big ellipticals we see nowadays. But it's not an automatic mechanism going from the left side to the right side and vice versa. That's actually the misnomer here is early type and late type. If you really want to associate something in terms of age with it, the early types are actually the older ones, while the late types are the younger ones. But people looked at these galaxies and thought, okay, they have almost no structure, so they must be still getting to the point where they have these structures like the other ones. But it's the other way around. Yes?
All right, so this might be a little silly, but so the you've got 14 billion as the age.
Roughly, yeah. 13.8.
That's also kind of, that's how far across, because that's how far we can see, right? With this beam
no.
of light. And,
no, we don't see 13.8. We see maybe a little bit less. Always keep in mind, at some point, it's just, the first signal we see is the microwave background. Now that is, that's fractions of a second after the but we do not see all the way to the Big Bang.
So it's literally just the fractions of a second left,
yeah.
though? Okay. So my question was, if that's the size that we can see,
yes.
that's literally just what we can see,
yes.
Doesn't that kind of imply that there is an infinite universe? I don't know, like, we definitely can only see to the finite.
Yes, we can
but
only
why
see
would that
to
mean
the finite,
that there's nothing else?
But from what we know about the universe, we know it's infinite.
Okay. Okay. Sorry. Yeah.
I have to go into more details about that.
That's
fair enough. Take a whole night. But.
Sorry.
So, is the farthest object we can see less than about 13 billion
yes.
light years, or
in terms of galaxies? Right. In terms of galaxies, yes. The earliest. Galaxy we currently see is that object I showed at a redshift of 11.9, which means it's about 400,000 years after the Big Bang.
I mean, expansion doesn't make it any further away?
No, including the expansion of the universe. That galaxy right now, holding the record, means that is when the first stars were born, 400,000 years after the Big Bang, before the universe was neutral. We now know that at least 400,000 years after the Big Bang, the first generation of stars have formed. We might even push that limit further back to the Big Bang, maybe 300,000, 200,000, that depends on how far out we can detect more galaxies. Right now, it's 400,000. And these numbers of 400,000 and so on, they always depend on what type of cosmology you use. So redshift is actually a much better measure because it's independent.
I'd like to invite you to come down and ask more questions with Lutz individually. So I also have some goodies for you. Posters to advertise. If you are off campus or even on, if you could take a few of these and just put them off because we're trying to get the word out. We don't have the advertising budget of the lectures, so if you could just take a few of these, we'd appreciate it. And any donations are tax deductible. If you want us to give credit to you with the donations office, put down your name. Thanks a lot.